Joining us right now, my good friend Julio Rosas, senior writer at townhall.com, and he has some of the best coverage out there. He's everywhere. Sometimes I worry about his safety. He doesn't care about safety. He cares about the story. And he joins us now. This is like one of the first times in a long time I've seen you in a normal office setting. You're like usually behind a truck somewhere. So it's good to talk with you. You've been down there, though. You covered all of this. You have a couple of really great pieces. How everything was cleared up for El Paso. The first thing I wanted to ask you is how do you think that the camps are now back on the sidewalk now that Biden's left and he's at the Three Amigos, is I guess what the press is calling it, summit?
I certainly think that, you know, what we saw in El Paso, because I was there twice last month, and it was just startling to see that within that 2 week time span, just how bigger the camps had gotten. And so it's not surprising at all that the city and Border Patrol really tried to clean up the area prior to his visit, because that has actually been standard operating procedure during this entire crisis. Whenever it's been Mayorkas or the Border Patrol chief or any members of Congress that come down to visit, they try to get out. They try to get as many people out of the processing centers as much as possible to try to not make it look as bad as it actually is. And it's not the frontline agents' fault. That's the upper management that are making those decisions. So I'm not surprised at all that when, you know, the commander in chief is coming down, they're going to do everything in their power to kind of downplay and minimize what's actually happening. And Kirby, in that same interview, he even said that Biden visited a processing center, but there was nobody being processed. It was empty. So
it's so weird. We're talking with our friend Julio Rosas at Town Hall. It's so weird that, and I understand that they're trying to present the best face of the city for the, you know, commander in chief when he comes to visit. But the reason he's there is to deal with the problem that the city is facing. So you would think that they would want him to see, especially when you have so many border state mayors and sheriffs and everybody else saying this is such a problem. We're worried about security, safety. We're worried about the resources of our areas. I mean, these aren't Martha's Vineyard type towns with, you know, billionaire vacation homes. I mean, these are average everyday Americans who just want to make sure that, you know, they're going to be okay and that they're not going to have cartels, you know, constantly intruding into their private property, bringing people over or drugs over. What do you think his response would have been? And I know this is, you know, maybe it's rhetorical, but if he actually would have seen how bad it is, the motorcade would have had to go through all of those encampments and they could actually see what the consequence of these policies are doing to towns like El Paso.
So actually, I was never a big proponent personally for Biden to go down and visit, because he obviously knows what's going on.
Right.
And I'm actually surprised he actually did. So, I mean, I'll give him kudos that he actually went down, at least to the area, for the first time in his, you know, multi-decade career. But I actually think that it's going to invigorate him and his team to double down on their policies even more, because to their view, they're going to think, oh, well, there's all these people sleeping on the street. There's like these massive lines that, you know, with all this, you know, big influx of people coming over. So we need to actually do more to process them more quickly, get them into the country faster, and just deal with the problem later. So I actually think that, you know, they would be shocked to see that, obviously, but then they would just be more hardened in their resolve to pursue their open border policy. So it befuddles the mind, because obviously conventional wisdom says the opposite of that.
Yeah.
But you have to understand, we're not dealing with a regular administration that actually wants to solve these problems.
Yeah, I think that's the big point, talking with Julio Rosas of Town Hall. And he's done some really great work on all of this. And he also has a book. If you haven't read it, you definitely should. It's called Fiery But Mostly Peaceful, The 2020 Riots and the Gaslighting of America. You had, I think you tweeted it, maybe Griff Jenkins had, looking at just the number of crossings in, for instance, El Paso sector alone. They said that it's up 220% from last year. The known gotaways, not even the unknowns, 78,161 known gotaways. The president announced this app that he says is going to make it easier for people coming across the border with to get processed and all this stuff. Is that actually going to be useful in this kind of situation? We all kind of scratched our heads here in the studio.
It will, to a certain extent, because the people, the nationalities that they're applying it to, the reason why that they are chosen with Cubans, Nicaraguans, is because right now they're making up a bulk of people who are crossing and willingly turning themselves in, you know, and so there's two camps, right? People who are willingly turning themselves in and the people who are trying to get away. So the people who aren't going to qualify for that, well, they're going to keep trying doing what they've always done, which is try to avoid Border Patrol or even risk it. If they're a family unit with small children, they'll risk turning themselves in. We'll see. I mean, they did do it with Venezuelans initially. That was like kind of the pilot program. And we did see a decrease in Venezuelans illegally crossing, but it was a twofold thing because a lot of them were waiting for December 21st when Title 42 was initially supposed to go away. When I was in Juarez, a lot of the people that weren't crossing and turning themselves in, they were Venezuelans. And there's
didn't they limit how many they were going to take too with Venezuelans? So I remember seeing somewhere cited, I think it was Border Patrol, that said, well, the gotaways actually increased because a lot it encouraged more people to come. But then when they realized that the program already had hit capacity for like that day or week, they couldn't be accommodated, and so there were the gotaways increased as a result of the cap or something.
Yeah, exactly. And it also depends on who Mexico is willing to take back. Since Mexico can flex their muscles, since they know that the Biden administration is not going to push back on like the Trump administration would, they definitely are in the upper. They know that they have the upper hand when it comes to these sensitive negotiations. And so I'll be interested to see what this meeting that Biden's in Mexico for, kind of what comes out of that, because we also have to remember that there's still a cartel war going down in Mexico, and they just captured a son of El Chapo, and that caused another major battle in a major Mexican city. So there's multiple things happening here all at once, and it, you know, stems back many decades, but you know what we have at our border is very much a symptom of the current administration, but also just the fact that Congress needs to address the immigration issue. But we'll see what happens.
We'll see. We were hobbling into this first week with Congress getting stuff done. Well, we're going to watch this and continue watching it, because this summit that they're having, I mean, I don't know. I got a full 60 seconds of Joe Biden looking confused just because Trudeau was speaking French at some when he arrived today at their. He just sat there and looked at him for a full 60 seconds confused. So I don't know if I have high hopes, but we'll see. You do such great work. And I hope if y'all haven't gone out and gotten his book, Fiery But Mostly Peaceful, The 2020 Riots and Gaslighting of America. He was right there in the thick of all of it, as he always is. Julio Rosas with townhall.com. Good to see you, my friend. Great work as always.
Thank you.
Of course.